cantidad que tiene para esquivar la cámara y la cámara de solo, usted la mantiene. Usted la pantoja de solo.
Good evening, people.
Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Hi, teacher.
Hello. How are you today?
Estoy con mis abuelos y estoy aquí los 4 días.
¿Cuánto más? ¿Cuánto más? ¿Cuánto más? ¿Cuánto más? ¿Cuánto más? ¿Cuánto más? ¿Cuánto más?
Yes.
Yes.
Good day.
Very good. Let me get the list.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. Okay. Okay, people, let's get started tonight. Welcome one more time to your English class with Inglés Corporativo Beginner 4. Hope you had a great day, a good day at work. Okay. We're going to start with the attendance and I'm going to ask you one of the questions we have in the last activity I gave you last night, okay? So we have 8 different questions in the chart I shared with you in WhatsApp, the last chart, el último cuadro que les compartí en WhatsApp. Okay, are you ready? Today is 22. Okay, let's start with Ana Lilian. Hello, Ana Lilian.
Hello, teacher.
Good evening. Question for you. Were you in your current job 5 years ago? Were you in your current job 5 years ago?
No, I was en otra compañía, ¿cómo diría?
¿Cómo se dice otro?
Other.
Other.
Other. Sería entonces, no, I was en other company.
Yes, okay. What company was that?
Antes o después.
5 years ago.
School Valentini.
School?
Sí, en un colegio.
Ah, okay.
Llamado yes, Valentini. Cool. Actual tramitaciones Ulloa.
Yeah, okay, good. Okay. Brian Javier. Are you here, Brian? I don't see her, him. Okay, I don't see him. Dinora really? Alejandra. Oh, ah, there you are. I don't see you. Okay, sorry, not responding. Dinora Alejandra Alfaro.
Present, teacher.
Ajá, Dinora. Were you late to your English class yesterday?
No, I wasn't. I was on time every day.
Every day, yeah. Good girl. Let me check every day. Ah, yes. Only one day you missed the class.
Okay. Yes.
Frida Janine Mejia.
Present, teacher.
Hello, Frida.
Present, teacher.
Tell us, Frida, was your last vacation exciting or boring?
Excuse me, teacher, I don't hear you.
Was your last vacation exciting or boring?
My last vacation was exciting.
Uh-huh. Why?
2 years ago, I'm going I went to Las Vegas.
Wow. Uh-huh. Interesting. Did you go to a casino?
No, it's more family trip because I have my husband go for a business travel, but I have family in Las Vegas.
Ah, okay. Okay, very good.
My husband going to go to Las Vegas. He's going to go to Las Vegas, but for business.
But he's going to go again in the future?
Yes, he's going to go to Las Vegas. Go to Las Vegas.
Ah, okay. Okay.
But I went on vacation.
Ah, okay. So he went to Las Vegas for business and you went on vacation?
Yes.
Ah, okay, good. Who's next? Guillermo Antonio García. Hello,
teacher,
Guillermo.
Present.
Brian. Te cayó falla, Brian. Where were you? Where Where were you? Do you understand my question?
Aquí en Amidich.
Who is Brian?
Es que estaba con mala conexión, profe. Y ayer no pude estar en la última hora ya no pude estar.
Ah, okay. Okay, Brian, tell us, was your lunch delicious today?
My lunch
delicious. Was delicious?
Yes, teacher.
Yeah. What did you eat?
Delicious.
What did you eat?
Chicken and verdura, no sé cómo se dice.
How do you say verduras, people?
Vegetables.
Yeah, vegetables. Okay, good. Guillermo. Is Guillermo here? No. Javier Aldair Escobar. Is Javier here?
Here, teacher. Here.
Where? I see you. Okay, Javier. Did you have a pet when you were a child?
Did you have a pet when you were a child? What is my pet, teacher?
What is the meaning of pet? Okay. Who can tell us what is a pet?
Mascota.
Quiero ver. Do you have a pet when you're with you? No, I not didn't pet in my, como si se niñez.
Childhood.
Childhood.
But I didn't have a pet.
But I had my first dog in April
this year,
and no, in this moment I had my first dog in April, teacher.
This year?
Yeah, in his year.
This year.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, very good, very good. Jose Arnoldo Mazariego.
I'm here, teacher.
Arnoldo, did you get your COVID vaccine already?
Yes, teacher. I completed my vaccine cartilla.
A card?
My vaccine card.
Ah, okay.
My vaccine card is complete 2 months ago.
2 months ago. Congratulations. That's good.
Thanks.
Okay. Now let's go with Galileo, Jose Galileo Barrera. He's not here, Galileo. That's weird. Jose Jonathan Vigil.
Present.
Hi, Jonathan.
Hi.
One question for you. Did you eat pupusas last week?
Yes, I did eat pupusas. I ate pupusas last week.
Ah, okay. How many pupusas do you eat, Javier? Jonathan?
3 pupusas on Friday.
Ah, 3? Only 3?
Yes, but it's big. They are big.
Ah, okay. Okay. Good. Jose Rodrigo Hernandez.
Process, teacher.
Rodrigo, let me ask you, did you have a girlfriend when you were in high school?
Yes.
Yes.
I did. Yes, I did. Her what? Name was Glory.
What was her name?
Yes. Gloria.
Gloria.
Yeah.
My wife's name is Gloria.
Yes.
Interesting.
But you don't live in Santa Tecla.
No, San Salvador. No.
Oh, okay, okay.
Okay.
Okay, Catherine, Marcela, Castaneda.
Hello, good evening.
Good evening, Catherine. Catherine, were you in your current job 5 years ago?
No, teacher.
No?
I'm staying my actually job 6 months ago.
Ah, and what about 5 years ago? Where were you?
Where I work in different places, for example, Simán, Prisma Moda, Starbucks, and I worked in there in the 5 years ago.
Ah, okay. And now?
And now I work with Banco Promérica.
Ah, okay, okay, very good.
Yeah.
Thank you. Laura Carolina Vigil. Let me ask Laura.
Hi. You... Hi, teacher.
Hello, Laura. Okay. Were you late last were you late to your English class yesterday?
Yes, I was late. Ah. I arrived after 7 minutes.
Okay. Good. Maria Concepcion Cerón.
Present, teacher.
Hello.
Good evening.
Tell us, Mary, was your last vacation exciting or boring? ¿A quién mandaron a callar ahí? Mary, we cannot hear you. Turn on your microphone.
Sorry, teacher. my vacation it is boring.
Is or was?
Was boring.
Was boring. Oh, why?
Yes.
Why?
Solo me dieron 8 days. Me quedaron debiendo 100.
Only 8 days? Oh, okay.
Yes.
That is not enough. Okay, good. Maria Ivania Palma.
Present, teacher.
Hello, Ivania. Was your lunch delicious today?
Yes, it was.
Ah, what did you eat?
I eat chicken with onion, my favorite food.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
But I eat or I ate?
I ate.
Remember, we were talking eight. In past.
Past
it
yes.
Is present. Eight. Is past. Okay, good. Mauricio Antonio Rivera.
I'm here, present.
Okay, Mauricio.
I have a problem in the connection. The website.
Okay.
I'm here.
Tell me, Mauricio, did you have a pet when you were a child?
A little cat. Her name is Rambo.
Is or was?
Was, excuse me, was.
Her name is was Rambo. Ah. Okay, good. Mayra Veralice Moreno.
Hi.
Hello, Myra. Tell me, Myra, did you get your COVID vaccines already?
Me lo puede repetir, teacher.
Okay. Did you get your COVID vaccines already?
Yes, I did, but I still have one dose.
Ah, okay. When are you going to get the second?
August 10th.
Ah, okay. Very good. That's important. Zaira Marlene Larin.
Present, teacher.
Hello, Zaira.
Hello.
Tell me, Zaira, did you eat pupusas last week?
Yes, teacher.
Ah, it's a good Salvadorian.
For the diet, we only leave for Sunday.
Only on Sunday?
Only on Sunday.
How many pupusas did you eat on Sunday?
Two.
Okay.
Only two.
Wendy Maribel Zabaleta.
Hello, present.
Hello, Wendy. Okay. Uh-huh, Wendy, confess.
Boyfriend, love and boyfriend, ¿cómo se dice? From me.
But in high school, did you have a boyfriend in high school?
No, I didn't. I had a boyfriend after high school.
You had a boyfriend after high school?
Yes.
Ah, what was his name?
I don't remember.
I don't believe
it's the past. It's past.
Okay, yes. Okay. Now, let's continue with Jacqueline Gloribel Rivas.
Good evening.
Hello, Jacqueline.
Hello.
Were you in your current job 5 years ago?
No, I was in study.
You were studying?
Yes.
Ah, okay. When did you start in your current job?
8 months ago.
Ah, okay. Very good. To get a job in this pandemic is not easy. Oh, good. Yes. For you. Okay, let's continue with Karen Vanessa Moratasha.
Hi, Fisher. Good evening.
Hello, Karen. Were you late to your English class yesterday, Karen?
No. I was in time.
On time?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Good girl.
Yes, obviously.
Mauricio Antonio Orellana? No. And Rocío Lourdes Pimentel?
Present, teacher. Good evening.
Hello, Rocío. Good evening. Was your last vacation exciting or boring?
It was exciting.
Good. Where did you go?
I go to the beach with my family the weekend.
You go or you went?
I went.
Okay.
I went with my family.
Okay, very good. Remember, people, when we talk about the past in affirmative sentences, you have to use the verb in the past form. Okay, I ate, I went, I visited,
Teacher, I have a question. And question number one, were you in your current job 5 years ago. Si mi respuesta es que sigo en el mismo trabajo, ¿cómo sería la si estoy hablando del presente?
Okay, para empezar. A ver, were you in your current job 5 years ago? A ver, people, ¿cómo responderían si están en su actual trabajo? O si estaban en su actual trabajo hace 5 años. Porque la mayoría que les he preguntado eso me han dicho, no, I wasn't. I was in another company or I was studying.
I was working my actual job.
Yes, I was in my current job.
Exactly. Yes, I was in my current job 5 years ago.
Okay.
I worked in my current job 5 years ago.
I worked.
Entonces, para empezar, ahí sería, ¿no? Yes, I was in my current job 5 years ago. ¿Qué era lo otro, Rocío?
Oh, only that, because I have 15 years working in the same company.
Ah, okay. Así sería.
Okay. Yes, I was.
Yes, I was.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, very good. Well, today we are going to continue talking a little bit more about the simple past. But first, let's go to the book. Let me share the screen. Okay. But actually, people, I want to remind you to complete the exercises in the platform. Oh, I forgot to check your exercises. Well, I'm going to do it tonight. But remember, today Thursday, tomorrow Friday, you must have finished. Tienen que haber terminado unit 3, okay, or section 3, ¿verdad? También por ahí les estoy dejando preguntitas, actividades en el foro de discusión que está en la plataforma. Solo como 2 o 3 entran ahí. Es decir, no es calificado, pero yo entiendo que no están aquí por una nota. Al final la nota es bien fácil sacarla, solo hacen las tareas y tienen la nota y pasan el módulo. Pero si eso es lo que quieren, ¿verdad? Eso se hace fácil. Pero yo sé que no están aquí por eso, sino que lo que quieren es manejar el inglés, hablarlo, leerlo, escribirlo, entenderlo. Entonces, mientras más practiquen, mejor, van a aprender, van a avanzar. Por eso les animo a los ejercicios de la plataforma, perdón, al foro de discusión para practicar. Dime.
I have a question in the exercise number 15. And don't have instructions for do it.
Vaya, tomémonos unos minutos para revisar ya. Incluso Arnoldo me planteó algunos casos también. Déjenme entonces abrir la plataforma o abrir la sección 3. Ya tengo acá listo. Okay, sería la bueno, aquí en la tarea, en la lección 11, todo
Bueno, nadie me ha dicho nada, que hay algún problema. En la lección 12, la tarea 12, me pone acá Arnoldo que el 2 y el 4. Exercise 2, ¿qué es lo que dice acá? Write the following positive sentences into negative past tense.
2, 3, and 5. Perdón, teacher.
2?
3 and 5.
3 and 5, veamos. I found $10 on the street. ¿Cuál sería la negative form?
I didn't.
I didn't.
I didn't.
I didn't find.
Veamos. $10. On the street. Three. I went to the beach last weekend. Yeah.
I didn't go to.
Didn't go to the beach last weekend. 2, 3, and 5.
Yes, I wasn't.
I flew to San Francisco last year.
I fly.
I didn't fly.
I didn't fly.
Francisco last year. Veamos estos tres. Arnold. Quizás, no sé.
I don't know, teacher, but
¿Será el punto final?
Maybe not. I tried to his form and no one time. Maybe 8 or 10.
¿Algún espacio de más?
I review this. Maybe 10 okay. Times.
Hay que revisar porque
don't work
instant.
For me. The other exercises was complete. This is the number 12, is the unit, and number 15 when the don't have instructions.
Instructions, bye. Veamos entonces el 15. Tarea. Este sería. Vale, déjenme ver.
Affirmative.
Eso es probablemente según se ve es cambiarlas a affirmative.
Yes.
Ajá.
Yes, teacher.
Si están negative, hay que cambiarlas a affirmative. Eso es en el ejercicio 15. ¿Alguien más que haya encontrado algún detallito?
The other.
La lección 13.
Sí,
la contesté bien. 13. Ajá, ¿qué pasa en la lección 13?
Que la 2 no me la dio correcta.
La 2. Vamos a ver. Instructions, create yes, no questions based on the answers provided. La 2, no, they didn't. They didn't check the information. ver, vamos a compartir pantalla. Estaba en la número 2, tarea 13, number 2, tenía que ser the day check, the information. Revisemos esa 2. Vamos a ponerle el signo porque no lo puse porque está ahí. Lo vamos a poner. Ahí está, eso era. Sí, hay que poner el signo de interrogación. ¿Ya?
Sí, teacher, thank you.
Okay, people.
Teacher.
Hola.
Yo en la 14, en el ejercicio 14, en la tarea 14, el 4, el 4. How were you all? Pero no me afecta de ninguna manera. No sé.
A ver. ¿Alguien?
Esa, pero no.
¿Cómo sería el orden? Ajá. How old?
Where are you?
Where are you?
Where are you?
How old were
how
you?
How old were you? Or, yes.
Veamos.
Ahí está. Oh, ok. Mire que cambié de todas maneras y no me afectó, teacher.
Igual me pasó, Laura. Probé mil y una.
Hasta el fin a ti, ¿no? Ok. Pero se oye como sin sentido el orden, teacher, pero no sé por qué el all.
Es que estamos acostumbrados a how old are you?
Ajá, o all you are.
Vaya. Y fíjense que todo or, lo que está haciendo... You? Todo lo que está haciendo es cambiando el are por where. Porque el presente es how old are you.
Creo que por lo autómata que uno es, teacher.
Ok. Yeah. Ok, teacher. Ahí está el sentido, teacher. Gracias. Por eso me había sacado menos 4 puntos menos, teacher.
Bye.
Gracias, gracias. Thank you.
Ok. Ok, bueno, cualquier otra duda ahí me avisan. Pero están bien los ejercicios, entonces no hay error ahí en la plataforma.
Gracias, teacher.
Perfecto. Ok, no problem. Ok, today we are going to study a little bit about this. Ask customers details about a problem they had to provide a solution. Bueno, vamos a ver un poco de eso, pero sobre todo el simple past and information questions. We have an email here about a customer's problem. Okay. Let's read this email. Let me read it for you. It's to Peter T. at jmail.com. The subject is complaint about a trip. The sender is hazer.r@jmail.com. Okay. And it says, last week I had the chance to travel with your company to another country. But to be honest with you, it was a bad experience because the bus that you assigned me in didn't have AC. It was a long trip and the bus was very slow. I am considering not traveling with you again because of the inconvenience I had. Okay. So who is the customer in this email? Who is the customer? Peter T or Hazer.R?
Peter T?
No, Hazer.
Hazer.
Okay. Yes. Hazer.
Hazer.
Yeah. He's the one sending the
yes from yes teacher.
Hazer from
okay. He's the customer. Reason. Okay. Good. When did Hazer travel with this company? Hello, when did Hazer travel to another country? Ah, last week. Yes. Last week, correct. Oh, it was a good experience?
No, it was a bad experience.
Ah, okay, it was a bad experience. Did the bus have air conditioning?
No.
It didn't.
No, it didn't. Okay. Didn't have air conditioning. Was the trip short?
No, it didn't.
No me estén mezclando was con did.
No, it wasn't.
Okay. Why?
Because bus was very slow.
Okay, but it was a long trip.
Sorry.
Was the bus fast? Was the bus fast?
The bus wasn't.
No, it wasn't.
Okay. How do you know that?
Was very slow.
This answer. Okay. Okay. Very good. Very good. Any question with the email? No?
No, teacher.
Okay. Very good. Well, we have some questions here about the email. Where did the passenger go? Why did the passenger consider it a bad experience? And what did the passenger send? What did the passenger send that email? What? No, that is bad. It must be why. Aquí está mal esta pregunta.
Why? Why, sorry.
En todo caso, sería why. Okay. Quizá va a ser un, porque ya está muy repetitivo. Cambiamos esta pregunta. Pongamos mejor. Cambiémosla por who did the passenger send this email to? Who did the passenger send this email to? Do you understand the question? ¿Qué estamos preguntando aquí?
¿Quién es? ¿Cómo? ¿Quién de los pasajeros envió el mensaje?
No.
No.
No, porque tenemos este to.
¿A quién le envió el
mensaje?
Exacto. Exacto. ¿Verdad? Vaya, entonces les voy a I'm going to send you to work in small groups to respond those three questions, okay? Y voy a poner esto en WhatsApp para que tengan la pregunta, una tercera pregunta ahí. Okay, and let's work in groups of three. Bye. Respond to questions, please. See you in 5 minutes.
Because the bus
that you were singing me didn't have aire acondicionado. No tenía aire acondicionado.
Okay. The bus.
Okay. The bus.
Va, pero. The bus didn't. ¿Cómo sería que va?
The bus didn't
hey, aire acondicionado.
The bus didn't. The bus didn't have air conditioner.
Bye.
La vamos a contestar como the passenger did go to travel another country.
The passenger did
go to travel another country. El pasajero fue a otra ciudad. Como le está preguntando, ¿dónde fue el pasajero? ¿Dónde fue el pasajero?
Another country. Sí, el pasajero. Pasajero sí fue.
Traduzca.
Pero el did lo usa cuando es pregunta de primero, pero en las respuestas.
Y también se puede usar para.
Yes, I did.
No, porque es que no es una afirmación, sino que solo
tenemos, teacher, tenemos esta respuesta para la primera pregunta, pero no estamos, no sabemos si está correcta, ¿verdad? Podemos utilizar, y no sé, esta respuesta. Yes, the passenger did travel another country.
Ustedes ya vimos cómo hacer oraciones afirmativas en pasado. Vamos, vamos, eso ya lo vimos.
Sería did another country.
I didn't.
No. El pasajero fue, como lo estamos afirmando, vamos a una respuesta afirmativa. El pasajero fue a otra ciudad. Entonces, para decir eso, tendría que ser the passenger did go to travel another country.
Nope.
No, teacher.
Y se los acabo de decir.
Ay, teacher, repix, por favor. Que esto está confuso.
Revisen cómo se hace una oración afirmativa en pasado.
Es. Teacher, pero como aquí la pregunta está en afirmativo, tendríamos que responder en negativo.
¿Por qué?
Sería country. Yes, it was.
Passenger, another
phone. Le están preguntando.
Yes, it was a passenger.
¿Qué les están preguntando?
¿De dónde fue la pasajera?
Vaya.
¿Dónde fue?
A otra ciudad.
Ciudad.
No sé si sería
a otro
así,
país.
Traveled. The passenger traveled to another country.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Teacher, thank you.
¿Por qué? Explícanos, Javier, ¿por qué?
como está preguntando, o sea, está mencionando, bueno, es una acción que ya se realizó, ¿verdad? Entonces, ajá, tendría que utilizar el verbo en modo pasado.
Exacto. Ajá,
entonces nosotros no estamos utilizando el pasado, sino que el presente.
Ajá, porque anteponíamos el estamos
diciendo el pasajero.
Fue.
No, estamos utilizando estamos diciendo el pasajero está viajando a otra ciudad, en vez de decir el pasajero okay. Viajó a otra ciudad.
Ok, entonces ajá. The passenger went, no, espérenme.
¿Sí? The passenger traveled to another city, another, ah. Another country, perdón.
Okay, thank you.
Vaya, vaya.
The passenger. Ya ve, Javier, que le estaba diciendo yo, corrija. Yo lo redacté mal, le dije yo.
I'm on automatic.
Okay, thank okay, you, teacher. Travel another.
Hello, teacher.
Hello.
Aprovechando, teacher.
Claro, dígame.
Está.
The passenger went to another country. Correct. The bus didn't have AC. Okay. The passenger sent the email to Peter. Perfect. Hey, very good. Congratulations.
Okay.
It's gonna be good if you, in the meantime, mientras terminan los demás, practican pregunta y respuesta a esto. The pronunciation, okay?
Okay.
Okay, see you.
Didn't have AC. ¿Cómo lo pusiste? Because the boss does assign that he assigned. Siempre pusiste he assigned.
No, the boss that the passenger assigned didn't have AC.
The boss. That the body passenger. Assign. No, porque ahí dirías que el pasajero asignó the passenger assigned. Se tendría que ponerle was, ahí tendría que llevar un was, that the bus, the passenger was assigned.
Ya lo habíamos mencionado y vos dijiste que no.
No, pero yo decía que no iba el he cuando decíamos because the bus that he assigned. Ahí yo decía que no iba el he, no iba él. El was, si va, was, si va, si lo ponemos de esa forma.
Sí, incluso habría que agregarle un to. ¿Dónde creen que iría ese to?
The bus that the passenger was to assign it.
No.
No.
Tiene que ser the bus that the passenger was assigned to. Sí.
Didn't have AC.
Didn't have AC.
And the number three. And the number three.
Okay, the passenger was assigned to didn't have AC, okay. Estábamos en un gran dilema.
Teacher.
Okay. Yep.
And the number one,
the passenger went to another country?
Yes. Good.
Correct.
Yep.
Okay. Y en el caso de la número 3, el verbo tendría que ir en pasado, sent.
Ajá. Uh-huh.
The passenger sent the email to hazard.ar.
Any person. O sea, podríamos poner a cualquier persona, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh.
In this case, it's punctually that hazard.r@gmail.com.
Mm-hmm.
Who did the passenger send this email to? ¿A quién le envió el email el pasajero?
Mm-hmm.
¿A quién le envió el email?
He sent the email.
A Mario, por ejemplo.
No, ahí está la dirección arriba.
Ah, sorry. Ah.
Hazard.r@gmail.com.
Ah, yeah.
Hazard.r@gmail.com.
Excellent.
Okay.
Hey, people. See you.
See you, teacher. Thank you.
Did you finish?
Hi. Yes.
Like any question?
No, teacher. No. From me. Okay.
Perfect. See you.
See you, teacher. Hey.
Acuérdense que el did solamente lo ocupamos para preguntar o para negar. Entonces, para mí, en la afirmativa tiene que ir pasado. Entonces, lo que sí podría cambiar es en lugar de ponerle el traveler, ponerle el go en pasado, que sería went, así como usted dice. Pero ya no usáramos el traveler. Solo went. Mm.
Teacher, tenemos un conflicto.
A ver.
Es que yo les digo a ellos de que vaya, si usamos el did, solamente se ocupa para negativos, entiendo yo, y para preguntas, no para las afirmativas. Entonces, en las afirmativas el verbo va en pasado. Entonces teníamos la duda si usar. Yo les decía, va, un ejemplo, she traveled, sí, va, traveled. Otra, no sé cómo se pronuncia, pero el pasado, o podía usar, y Maribania decía que podíamos usar el went, que es el pasado de go, pero no usar el travel y el went. Entonces eso es lo que estamos aquí deduciendo.
Entonces, ¿cómo quedaría?
Entonces, teacher, mi opinión, she went, travel, estaría correcto.
He went travel. No. You are using no. Two verbs.
Ah, lo que decía Wendy. Entonces solo sería she went.
Puede ser she went. O puede ser she traveled.
Ah, ya. Yeah. Traveling. Ok. Mm. Bueno, ya lo resolvió.
Thank you, teacher. Estamos okay. En esa cosa.
Entonces, she went with her company.
Okay, see you.
Ajá. Vaya, Pip.
Así la tiene como Gur.
Sí, pero lo que estoy viendo es que me separa mucho la N y la T cuando pongo la comita.
Nine latte. Y no tiene ahí en su computadora como corrector, because tiene que ponerla junto, si no, no se lo va a tomar como error en el sistema. Uh-huh. O sea, no le tiene que dar espacio entre el we wouldn't.
Uh-huh.
El we wouldn't like to stay in this place. Tiene que quedar unido el wouldn't. Porque si no, siempre se lo va a tirar como error.
Okay, people, welcome back. Let's check the questions quickly. Oh, where is, let me get it here. Okay, where did the passenger go? Tell me, Lillian.
Me repite la pregunta.
The number one, where did the passenger go?
The passenger travel a other city.
To another city?
Sí.
People, city?
Country.
Country.
No, country.
Country. Okay, no problem. It's okay. The passenger traveled to another country, or the passenger, algunos pusieron, went to another country. Está bien. ¿Alguien tiene una respuesta diferente? No. Okay. Number two, let me ask to Zaira. Zaira, why did the passenger consider it a bad experience?
The bus didn't have air conditioner.
Ah, okay. Okay. Just let me tell you that usually questions with why, we respond using because at the beginning. You know? Porque le están preguntando por qué. Entonces, eso se responde por qué. Y lo que dice Zaira, the bus didn't have air conditioner. ¿Verdad? ¿Y cómo se dice por qué?
Because.
Because. ¿Verdad? Because. ¿Todos saben cómo se escribe eso?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. The cause.
Because. ¿Verdad? Because the bus didn't have air conditioner. ¿Algo más? People?
Yes.
Ajá.
It was a long trip.
Ok, podríamos agregarlo porque dice ahí, ¿verdad? Why did the passenger consider it a bad experience?
Or the bus was very slow.
Sí, sobre todo eso, ¿verdad? Porque si el viaje es largo pero cómodo, pues bueno, no se siente. Pero básicamente es because the bus didn't have air conditioner and it was very slow.
Very low.
Ok. And the last, hola.
A turtle.
Okay. And the last question, let me ask to Rodrigo. Who did the passenger send this email to?
The passenger sent the email to Peter.
Okay, yes. Okay, very good, very good. Well, I'm going to take the second attendance and later after that, so we're going to study simple past questions or information questions, okay? Let's see, quickly please turn on your cameras, everybody. Yeah, perfect. Ana Lilian Reyes.
Present, teacher.
Ryan Javier Carmona.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Dinora Alejandra Alfaro.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Frida Janine Mejia.
Present, teacher.
Good. Gabriela Irene. No.
Mira.
Guillermo Antonio García.
Present.
Okay. Javier Aldair Escobar.
Here, teacher.
José Arnoldo Mazariego.
Present, teacher.
José Galileo Barrera. José Jonathan Vigil.
Present, teacher.
Catherine Marcela Castaneda.
Present, teacher.
Laura Carolina Vigil.
Present, teacher.
Quiero ver. Me salté a José Rodrigo Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Ok. María Concepción Cerón.
Present.
María Ivania Palma.
Present, teacher.
Mauricio Antonio Rivera.
Present, teacher. I'm here.
Mayra Veralisa Moreno.
Present.
Zaira Marlene Larín.
Present.
Wendy Maribel Zabaleta.
Present, teacher.
Jacqueline Gloribel Rivas.
Present.
Karen Vanessa Moratalla. Karen Vanessa, se nos cayó. Mauricio Antonio Arellana. Y Rocío Lourdes Pimentel.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Okay. Now let's take a look to these examples of information questions with in simple past and with be. Information questions. Well, actually simple past this. Okay. Look at these examples. Let me get the... What did you buy? I bought a vacation package. Where did he fly to? He flew to another country. When did we pay for the service? We paid for the service last month. How did they find out of that promotion? This off is not necessary. How did they find out that promotion? They found out about it on internet. Okay. So let me show you this chart to talk about information questions. Oops. Uh, Okay, first I want to review. Okay. Information questions with was or were. Okay. Singular and plural. Let me get this. Okay. For example, who? ¿Qué pasó? Aquí está.
I'm here, sorry. Se me descargó el teléfono y se me apagó.
Who was I? Pregunto un poco rápido. ¿Qué estoy diciendo? Primero, la pregunta es: les voy a enviar. Hacemos solo que estén en el mismo. Where I go with she, how did you read? How do you read the report? Then, entonces, estructura, recordemos, information, la pregunta, luego, did, siempre va a ser did, luego el subject, ¿verdad? Y por último, el verbo, que ya dije, pregunta, se va a y esto que sería, claramente, she wrote many books, included the Harry Potter series. Y leamos acerca de Frida. Dice, Frida Kahlo lived in Mexico. She painted self-portraits. She got married to Diego Rivera. Acá les pongo 4 o 5 preguntas acerca de J.K. Rowling y Frida Kahlo. The first question says, who did Frida marry to? ¿Verdad? Who did Frida marry to? ¿Quién me puede responder? ¿Cómo?
Tú y River.
Y la otra.
Es la forma de usar.
Me dice por.
Entonces
ella
se
está leyendo. Y es Elena.
No sé también qué le parece. What was
no te dijeron nada a ella.
Record
primero resumir un paragraph about J.K. Rowling y luego quiero que me hagan dos respectivas respuestas. ¿Está claro lo que van a hacer?
Sí.
Ahí el WhatsApp. Ok.
Cuando ella tenía 17.
Ah, sí, su primer álbum cuando ella tenía 17 años.
Ajá, o sea que la recuerdan porque estaba bien chiquitita. Entonces, cuando hizo su primer álbum. Entonces podemos poner que cuántos años.
Pero ¿cuántos años tenía?
¿Cómo sería? ¿Cuántos años tenía?
Bueno,
¿qué edad?
When she was.
O porque es recordada ella, no sé, para usar el recordar.
Why?
Mm-hmm.
Why did sería entonces?
Why the caller?
Por. Ay, no, no sé. Ya me perdí. Pero sería. Espera. She recorded her first album when she was 17. No, when she 17. Quiero ver.
Why did Selena Gomez?
Why did Selena Gomez
record?
Así va. Y ahí, ahí ponemos. Why did.
¿Por qué recordada Selena? ¿O por qué es recordada Selena Gomez?
Why did
Selena Gomez?
Why did Selena Gomez record?
Entonces podemos poner Selena Gomez recorded her first album.
Pero dice why did Selena Gomez is record? No.
Yo creo que se va Liz.
Sí, porque como why did ya no podemos usar el was. Y es recordada, estamos poniendo, entonces is record.
Selena Gomez is record. La respuesta, Selena.
Is record.
Is recorded. Recuerda aquí en pasado, recordada.
Why did Selena Gomez is
her first
Selena Gomez
album
was record. No. Quiero ver.
No.
Selena
is recorded. Gomez. Ahí sería en pasado el verbo. Selena es recordada. Gomez. Her first album. When, cuando tenía 17 años. When she was.
She did. No entiendo mucho la respuesta. Sería Selena Gomez. Es que no podemos poner y.
Hi, teacher.
Hello.
We finished.
Oh. Can I hear your questions, please?
Okay. Where did Robert Downey Jr. act? And the answer is Robert Downey Jr. act in movies and TV series. Ahora tú, Mauricio, el otro.
Okay. Dice, was when, no, when was J.K. Rowling born? Oh, sería what books did J.K. Rowling write? Yo le puse, bueno, pusimos, she wrote many books, included Harry Potter series.
Quiero escuchar las preguntas que ustedes hicieron.
The Robert Downey Jr.
Y Selena.
Yo puse, ajá, yo puse. Permíteme, yo puse. When was Robbie Downey Jr. born?
Okay.
He was born on 1977. Y la otra le puse 65.
Ok, una está bien. A ver, Jonathan, ¿está ahí? Are you there, Jonathan? Que este se va, ya se nos fue. Ok, Dinora, another question?
Ok, teacher, for Selena... Where was Selena actress?
Mm-hmm.
And the answer is she was a Disney actress. No estoy segura si la pregunta está correcta.
No, yo hago.
Where was Selena an actress, tal vez? An actress.
Where was Selena an actress? Yeah.
She was a Disney actress.
Okay. And another one. La otra es Selena.
She was. When was Selena Gomez born? She was was born in 1992.
Okay, good. Please practice asking question answer. Practiquen entre ustedes haciéndose la pregunta y respondiendo. Son varias ahí para practicar. Okay.
Okay, teacher.
See you.
Thank you.
How many movies?
How many? En cuántas películas?
How many movies?
Where are you, man?
Robert Downey
actor como Iron Man.
Yes.
Uh-huh. How what? Many?
How is many movies?
How many movies?
Iron Man, Robert Jr.
How what many is, movies? Robert Downey Jr. acted. Pero ahí sería how many movies?
How many pero movies did?
El did, ahí va.
Did, tenemos que ocupar el did entonces.
Ah, correcto.
How many movies did I act?
How many as, movies did
que está como
Robert Downey's actor?
Ajá.
Act, pero ahí sin las. Solo act. How many did?
How many did? ¿En cuántas películas actuó?
No, it's how many movies did. Ay, no.
Thank you.
Okay, welcome back, people. Okay, very good. Let's check your work. Veamos primero las preguntas que estaban ya hechas solo para responder. A ver, preguntémosle a Dinora. What books did J.K. Rowling write?
She wrote J.K. Harry Potter series and many books.
Okay, yes, perfect. She wrote. Next question, please. Let me ask to Hey, this guy is always leaving. Arnoldo is here. Ya se fue. Entonces preguntémosle a a ver, Jacqueline. When was J.K. Rowling born?
Robert born in
J.K. Rowling.
J.K. Rowling born in no sé cómo se lee, 1965.
De dos en dos. 1965. Correcto. Okay, but J.K. Rowling was born in 1965, correct. And then, Jonathan, what did Frida paint?
What did Frida paint? She painted self-portrait.
Self-portraits. Okay. Okay. Good. Ok, ahora quisiera escuchar las preguntas que ustedes hicieron. Empecemos con Zaira. Una pregunta de las que ustedes hicieron.
Ok, teacher. When did Selena Gomez record her fifth album? Esa sería la pregunta.
Ok, muy bien.
Selena was record first album when she was 17, ¿cómo se dice? Me olvidó.
17
years old.
Vaya, pero ahí en esa respuesta hay algo de más. ¿Qué está de más?
El was será antes. Ajá. De usted.
Exacto. ¿Cómo sería entonces?
Selena was record first.
No. Selena record.
Selena record first album when she was 17 years old.
Okay. Ese primer was estaba de más.
Okay.
Y recorded. Thank you. Recorded. Okay. Recorded. Recorded. Pasado, ¿no? Selena recorded her first album when she was 17. Okay, good. A ver, sigamos con Guillermo. Guillermo está congelado. Entonces, vámonos con Wendy. Una pregunta, Wendy, cualquiera de las que ustedes hicieron.
Cualquiera, ok. Mm. Ay, pero este se parece. Bueno. When was Selena Gomez born?
Okay, good question. And the answer?
Selena Gomez was born in 1992.
Okay, perfect. Excellent. Let's see. Let's continue with Rocio.
Okay. What was the most famous movie of Robert Downey Jr.?
Okay.
The most famous movie was Iron Man.
Okay, very good, very good.
Teacher, how do you say La Saga de Iron Man?
La Saga.
Ajá, porque no solo es una hay una saga de películas.
Yeah. Good question. Let me check. Let me check. Give me a second. Unta, aquí está. La saga. Me parece que es algo parecido, pero I'm not sure.
No es saga, teacher, así como saga. No. No hay como una definición para saga. Así.
Saga. Yeah. Saga, saga. Mm-hmm. It's the same in English. A ver, aquí está. Vamos a escucharlo. Vamos a verlo. Look, saga. This is the same in English, saga, epic story. Vamos a ver. Compartir sonido. Aquí está. Otro día, word reference. ¿Sí? ¿Me están viendo? ¿No?
Saga.
¿Me escucha? Oh,
okay. Yes.
Yes. Saga. Dijo.
Saga. Ya, yeah, es lo mismo en English and in Spanish, right? Basically. Saga. Okay. Okay. Very good. Okay, now let's continue with one more, just to check your questions. One more. Ivania. Deme una pregunta de las que hicieron.
Where was Selena Gomez actress?
Okay, where was Selena Gomez? Mm-hmm.
Selena Gomez was a Disney.
A Disney actress.
Actress.
A Disney actress. Okay, very good, very good. Vaya, les voy a pedir que en el foro de discusión de la plataforma, en la clase de hoy, me pongan ahí las cuatro preguntas que hicieron. ¿Verdad? Así todos las pueden ver y podemos compartir eso. ¿Ok? Ahí en el foro de discusión, ahí me las ponen, por favor. Okay, people, that would be all for today. Today's personal session is with Galileo, pero Galileo no entró a clase hoy. Si alguien la quiere tomar los 10 minutos de hoy, dígame ahora, por favor. Mientras tomo la asistencia, me avisa a alguien si quiere los 10 minutos de hoy para que practiquemos un poquito más. ¿Ok? Y quiero ver, tengo otro cuadrito, pero mañana lo vamos a trabajar. Mañana, que es el repaso de todo lo visto en la semana, vamos a reforzar más esto de preguntas en pasado. Veo que todavía les cuesta un poco, ¿verdad? Entonces vamos a reforzar esto de cómo hacer preguntas en pasado y oraciones en pasado. Ok. Good. Ana Lilian Reches.
Present, teacher.
Ok. Thank you for attending. Brian Javier Carmona.
Present.
Okay, thank you for attending. Dinora Alejandra Alfaro.
Present, teacher. Good night.
Good night. Frida Janine Mejia de Celaya.
Present, teacher. Good night.
Everyone. Thank you. Good night. Guillermo Antonio García Sánchez. Se le cayó. Javier Aldair Escobar Morales.
Present, teacher.
Thank you for attending. José Arnoldo Mazariego. José Galileo Barrera, no entró. José Jonathan Vigil.
Present.
Okay. José Rodrigo Hernández.
Present.
Thank you for coming. Catherine Marcela Castaneda.
Present, teacher.
Thank you for attending. Laura Carolina Vigil. Laura.
Present, teacher.
Uy, casi no se le escucha.
Ok, present.
Good. María Concepción Cerón.
Present.
Good. María Ivania Palma.
Present.
Good. Mauricio Antonio Rivera.
Present, teacher, I'm here.
Excellent.
Good night, bless.
Bless you. Mayra Veralice Moreno.
Present.
Okay. Zaira Marlene Hilarín.
Present.
Good. Wendy Maribel Zabaleta.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Jacqueline Gloribel Rivas.
Present. Good night.
Good night. Karen Vanessa Moratalla. Karen Vanessa. She's gone. Mauricio Antonio Reyana. Didn't show up. Rocío Lourdes Pimentel.
Present.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Teacher.
Hola.
Una pregunta. ¿Cómo ingreso al foro de discusión? Porque por eso no he ingresado, porque no sé cómo hacer.
Le muestro ahorita. En la plataforma, sí tiene ingreso a la plataforma, ¿verdad?
Sí, ya estoy aquí adentro.
Ahí debajo de los videos. Bueno, voy a compartirle la pantalla. Ahí dice añadir un tema o algo así, dice. Ya. Bueno, debajo del video de cada clase. Ahí está. Sí, añade una publicación.
Ok.
O si le da clic en la publicación que ya está, creo que le abre directamente eso. ¿Ve? Y le dice añade una respuesta.
Ok.
¿Ve? Y ahí va. Aquí está donde añade tu respuesta. Escribe ahí y le da a enviar. Y ya queda ahí guardado.
Ok. Thank you.
Ok.
Good night.
Okay, have a good night.
Good night.
Good night, Wendy.
Thank you.
Hoy es la clase 14.
Ay, teacher, todavía me está fallando el teléfono. Ya para salir.
Hola.
Hola, teacher.
Ajá, Karen.
Lo siento, aquí se me está desconectando el libro cada rato, pero ya termina la clase. Pero aquí está.
Bueno, bueno.
Bye. Todo.
Ok. Goodbye, Karen. Have a good night. Mm-hmm.